starting very soon.
Saudara-saudari dalam Kristus, kita akan mulai sebentar lagi.
So those at the back, please be seated.
Jadi yang di belakang sila duduk dan jangan lari.
Ya, yeah, jangan lari. So good morning and blessed Sunday. I'm Jeremy. I'm one of the pastors here in PJEFC.
Selamat pagi. Beliau adalah Jeremy. Dia merupakan seorang pastor di PJEFC.
And here is Edwin standing beside me. He will be translating into BM for
saya
me.
Adalah, nama saya Edwin. Saya akan menterjemahkan untuk Pastor Jeremy.
So welcome to our combined worship service this morning.
Jadi selamat datang kepada ibadah raya gabungan pada pagi ini.
This is a place where we love God, love people, and make disciples.
PJEFC merupakan gereja yang mengasihi Allah, mengasihi sesama sendiri, dan mengamalkan pemuridan.
So today there are people of God from English Church, from BM, from Chinese, Nepalese, and Urdu congregation.
Jadi terdapat 5 jemaat pada pagi ini dari bahasa Inggris, bahasa Malaysia, Urdu, Nepali, dan bahasa Cina.
So I will teach you all a simple Nepalese greeting to get things started.
Pastor Jeremy akan ajarkan satu ucapan Nepali untuk memulakan ibadah raya ini.
So it is Jai Masih, meaning God is victorious.
Jai Masih, yaitu Allah memberi kemenangan.
Jai Masih. So turn to your neighbors and greet them with this greeting. Jai Masih.
Kata kepada kiri kanan, Jai Masih.
Three people.
3 orang, ah.
So we will be starting the service here in just a moment. Doreen and the team, they will be leading us in worship.
Jadi kita akan mulakan sebentar lagi. Doreen dan tim pelayanan dan tim pujian penyembahan akan bermula.
After that, I will come up to lead us in corporate prayer and then give you the announcements.
Selepas itu, Pastor Jeremy akan naik dan memimpin kita dalam doa corporate dan memberi pengumuman.
After the announcement, we will release the children for Sunday school.
Selepas pengumuman, kita akan membebaskan kanak-kanak untuk pergi ke sekolah minggu.
And then we will have baptism.
Dan pembaptisan juga akan berlaku.
After that, we will have Pastor Daniel Jimmy to come forth to give us the word this morning.
Selepas itu, Pastor Daniel Jimmy akan kongsikan firman Tuhan dengan kami.
And Sister Nelly will be his interpreter.
Dan Sister Nelly akan menjadi penterjemahnya.
With all that being said, we are going to start the service in just a moment, and let us now bow our heads and pray to
mari
begin the worship service.
Mari kita siapkan hati kita untuk menyembah Tuhan.
Let us bow and let us pray.
Mari kita berdoa.
Lord, we come to you this morning to behold your glory and beauty. You are incomparable in your love and goodness, wisdom and strength. You are our only hope and you are our only boast. Fill us with your joy and delight as we adore your holy name. May you reign forever and your presence fill this sanctuary, and your glory shall cover the entire world. All praise, honor, and glory be unto Jesus forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you. Good morning, everyone. Selamat pagi. I don't speak Mandarin, sorry. Okay, now, my name is Doreen, and this is our worship team, including up there as well, you know, our sound crew and our visual crew, AV crew. I'd also like to introduce Jane, as well as Elvon from the BM Church. Thank you so much, Jane and Elvon, for joining us. Oh, no. No need for applause, but I'm going to ask of a favor. Okay, so I know, you know, today everyone here looks wonderful, and we are just so happy to have you here. If this is not normal place for you on Sunday morning in this sanctuary, we are delighted that you are joining us today. Yeah? So can I just get a show of hands? Who is from the Urdu community, the Urdu church? Urdu church, everybody. All right, lovely. Okay, now. Who is from the Chinese church? Chinese church. Thank you for joining us. And I think Pastor Jeremy as well is somewhere, right? Yeah. Okay, who is from the Nepalese church? Sorry, I didn't see any hand, but I believe there's some here. At the back. Oh, on top. Oh, okay, they're all on top. Hi. Okay, so later you all know where to go. Huh? They're all on top, yeah? Balcony, okay. Who is from the BM Church? BM Church? Ooh, check out that energy! You all come on stage. Yeah, okay, so, and English Church is the rest of us, correct? Okay, so let me ask for favor. Everybody rise. Okay, English Church, here is the task. I'm going to put the responsibility on English church congregations. English church congregants. Okay. Go and say hello to somebody who is not in your church community. Okay? So remember, the Nepalese church is up there. So some of us go up there and welcome them. I'm going to give us 3 minutes for this. Come on. Let's be a welcoming PJEFC community. And over here on stage, I'll say hello to Jane. Because Jane and Elvon are my only representatives. Hi, Elvon. Yeah, BM Church is in front. Chinese Church is all over. And don't forget the Nepali Church on top. Urdu community. Yeah, did I miss any other churches? Do we have a French church? We don't, not yet. We don't have French church. Yeah, just mingle around, you know, it's a wonderful morning, you know, that we get to gather everybody here. Yeah, it's just another 1 minute. Yeah, get your energy levels up. Yeah. Okay, and after you're done, come back to your place and remain standing. Because, you know, that would be a fantastic introduction for our next song. Yeah, okay. And? All right. Ooh, okay. Everybody's done? Okay, if you're done, hands up. Who's done? Hands up. Hands up. Ah, okay. Most of us are done. Is it? Okay, all right. So, we're going to start with our first song. We're going to go through a series of songs. Just a heads up, these songs will be sung in different languages. So, if you're like me and you don't know all the languages, here's your opportunity to learn a little bit. All right, Ken? And I also want to encourage everybody, you know, I know not everyone is familiar with this sanctuary and the way that we do things. However you want to worship God this morning, please feel free to do so. If you like to clap instead of sing, please clap along with us. If you like to be silent and worship from your heart, yes, do so as well. As long as you just set yourself free to worship the one and true God. Amen? Yeah, okay. So with that, let's begin. Segala puji syukur. Hands together.
Sorang di dalam hati.
Jesus, evokes beauty. Your name evokes wonder and majesty. And Lord, we just want to give you thanks because you and you alone, Lord, are worthy of our praise and glory. You and you alone are the giver of all love, all mercy, all praise. This next song is familiar to many of us in the English congregation, but today we are going to be singing it in Mandarin. So for those of you who, like me, did not take the opportunity to learn Mandarin when we were younger, now's the time to redeem ourselves. I'd like to invite Alexia and later Martin to lead us in this song.
Yeah. Salibmu menjadi sumber kekuatan, mengingatkanku akan kasihmu yang tiada batas. Karena salibmu kami hidup, karena salibmu kami menang. Amin.
Hanya kau Tuhan di hidupku, only you God. Kau berikan hidup yang baru. Pulihkan hatiku, ku nyatakan
jiwaku pun berserah hanya kepadamu. Yesus, kaulah segalanya. Karena salibmu ku
continue to come before you with grateful hearts, amazed by the love you have shown us today through the cross of Jesus. It is because of your cross, Karena salibmu, that we are forgiven and free, and we thank you for this undeserved grace.
Bapa Surgawi, kita mengharap Engkau dengan hati yang penuh kesyukuran kagum akan kasih-Mu di atas salib Yesus. Oleh karena salib-Mu, dosa kita diampuni dan kita dibebaskan, dan kita berterima kasih kepada-Mu untuk kasih karunia-Mu.
And as we gather here today, may your presence fill this place and touch every heart. Let the message of the cross be heard clearly and draw people close to you. Help us to live in the power of the cross day by day.
Sewaktu kita berkumpul pada pagi ini, semoga hadirat-Mu memenuhi tempat ini dan menyentuh setiap jiwa. Biarkanlah kuasa Injil-Mu nyata kepada semua dan umat-Mu tertarik kepada-Mu.
In response to your sacrifice, teach us to surrender our lives unto you. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in us and through us.
Ajarlah kita untuk menyerahkan diri kepada-Mu dan melayani orang lain dengan penuh rendah hati karena pengorbanan Engkau.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Di dalam nama Tuhan Yesus kami berdoa. Amen.
Amen. So please be seated.
Sila duduk.
Once again, good morning and welcome to PJEFC's combined worship service today.
Sekali lagi, selamat pagi dan salam sejahtera kepada semua yang datang bergabung dengan kami dalam ibadah gabungan PJEFC.
So it's good to see all of you here. So many people today.
Sangat berbesar hati kami melihat ramai orang pada pagi ini.
If you are new with us, we want to if you are new with us, we want you to feel welcome and feel at home.
Jika anda pertama kali bersama kami, kami sangat mengalu-alukan hadirat anda.
And one of the best ways that you can get connected with us is that after the service, you can go to the visitors lounge located outside at the Kopitiam area, and then you can talk to some of us leaders, you can interact with us, and we can also help you to get to know the church.
Salah satu cara untuk saling mengenali adalah selepas ibadah hari ini, kita keluar ke bilik menyambut tetamu di luar gedung gereja ini.
So it is a busy season here in PJEFC. There will be a few announcements, so please take note of these announcements.
Terdapat beberapa pengumuman, jadi sila ambil perhatian ya.
After the announcement, we will go into baptism.
Selepas pengumuman, pengumuman adalah baptism.
The first announcement is extended prayer meeting.
Yang pertama adalah persekutuan doa berlanjutan.
So this is the final extended prayer meeting for this year on Wednesday, 16th of October.
Ini merupakan persekutuan doa berlanjutan yang terakhir untuk tahun 2024 yang akan berlangsung pada 16 Oktober.
8 p.m. and so we welcome all of you, encourage all of you to join in this extended prayer meeting.
Pada pukul 8 malam di chapel, jadi kita mengalu-alukan semua untuk hadir.
Next announcement, Christian Education, a talk on Trinity.
Yang kedua merupakan satu kelas ataupun sesi tentang Tritunggal.
We know that the Trinity is one of the central doctrine for our Christian faith, yet it is also one of the most misunderstood and one of the, we say that it is a mysterious doctrine.
Jadi Tritunggal itu merupakan salah satu asas doktrin agama Kristian, tetapi ia juga merupakan salah satu doktrin yang ramai orang tidak begitu fasih.
So if you have questions about the doctrine of Trinity, we want to invite you to this particular class, CED, Introduction to the Trinity.
Jadi jika anda mempunyai pergumulan tentang Tritunggal, kami menjemput anda untuk menghadiri kelas ini.
So we have invited Dr. Mark Knight, the principal of STPC, to come and give us this talk.
Kami telah menjemput Dr. Mark Knight, pengetua SPTC, untuk memberikan kelas ini.
It is on 20th of October, after the Sunday service.
Kelas ini akan berlangsung pada 20 hari bulan Oktober selepas ibadah Ahad.
No registration is required. You can just walk into
anda
the class.
Anda tidak perlu berdaftar, free ya, percuma.
Free, yes. Food bank collection.
Okay, bank makanan.
So we always have this food bank collection, and the upcoming one is on 19th of October, Saturday.
Jadi bank makanan kita akan mengumpul makanan pada 19 Oktober hari Sabtu.
3 to 4 p.m. at the basement canteen.
Pukul 3 hingga 4 di basement canteen.
So there is a list for a list of items needed. You can visit our PJEFC website, Kita Jaga Kita.
Sila lari laman web PJEFC, Kita Jaga Kita, untuk melihat senarai keperluan yang kita perlukan.
Moving on, children program.
Keempat, acara kanak-kanak.
So after the announcement, we will release the kids to a wonderfully prepared children program.
Jadi selepas pengumuman, kita akan menghalau semua kanak-kanak ke.
So if your kids are preschool age, 0 to 6, please exit the hall, go up the stairs on the left, and find your class. There will be teachers there to guide you.
Jadi jika anak kamu berumur di antara 0 hingga 6 tahun, sila naik tangga ke kiri selepas keluar dari gedung gereja ini. Dan cari kelas yang berkenaan. Terdapat guru-guru yang akan menjaga dan memimpin anak kamu.
If you are primary school age, 7 to 12, please turn left when you exit and you will be in a big hall called Studio One.
Jadi jika anak kamu berumur di antara 7 hingga 12 tahun, sila pusing kiri selepas keluar dari gedung gereja ini dan lihat pergi ke bilik Studio 1.
Alright, so parents, you can pick up your children after the service.
Ibu bapa, anda boleh menjemput anak-anakmu selepas ibadah selesai.
And for babies and toddlers, feel free to go with them.
Untuk ibu bapa kepada bayi-bayi dan anak kecil, sila mengikuti mereka.
Now I will invite Edwin to pray for the Sunday school as we release the children.
Mari kita doakan untuk anak-anak sekolah minggu. Tuhan Yesus, kami bersyukur, berterima kasih Engkau telah memberkati gereja kami dengan jiwa-jiwa yang sangat sangat berharga ini. Kami doa agar mereka dapat mempelajari lebih mendalam lagi tentang kasih Tuhan Yesus dalam hidup mereka. Dan kami serahkan semua guru-guru sekolah minggu untuk menunjukkan satu contoh Tuhan Yesus yang nyata di dalam hidup mereka. Di dalam nama Tuhan Yesus kami berdoa. Amin.
Amin. Now the children are released. Please go to your Sunday school.
Okay, silakan kanak-kanak keluar.
So now, as the children is exiting the hall to their Sunday school, we have come to the baptism segment for today. Today is Baptism Sunday, so this is the time where our baptismal candidates, they have chosen to take that step of faith to publicly testify about their faith that they trust in our Lord Jesus. So while our Lord Jesus was on earth, he instituted two ordinances. Can some of you shout out what are these two ordinances? One of it is water baptism. What is the other one? I heard Lord's Supper, Holy Communion, correct? So two. One is the Holy Communion, and today we are going to carry out the second one, water baptism, as commanded in Matthew 28:18-20. So this is a common passage that we know. Jesus came to the disciples and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And lo and behold, surely I am with you always to the end of every age." So this is a command from Jesus to all his disciples that they are to be baptized. And Romans chapter 6, verse 4, reminds us of the spiritual significance of baptism, that we were therefore buried with him through baptism into death, in order that just as Christ was raised from the dead through the glory of the Father, we too may live a new life. So baptism is a public identification with Christ, that we have died with him, we are now buried with him, and then later on we raised to life together with Christ. So that Jesus Christ, as Jesus Christ is resurrected from death to life, so when the candidates, they come out from the water, this also represents, symbolizes that they are now entering into a new life. They are now a new creation. So may I now invite the baptism candidates up to the stage to be presented to the church. So I will be calling out your names one by one, all right? So let us welcome them. The first candidate is Daniel Adele. Right, and then next we have a candidate from Chinese Church, Brother Yong Long. And next we have Daniel Goh. And next let us invite the English Church candidates, Yuan Lai Cheng. Sister Lillian, Sister Zi'en, Sister Jialing, Brother Edison, Brother Marcus Wee, Brother Brandon Lee, Brother Jaden, and Brother Kendrick. Now we invite two candidates from Udu PJ, Brother Emmanuel Masse and Brother Vishal Masse. All right, and now we want to proceed to invite those from Udu Kepong, Sister Zarina, Sister Shazia Naim, Sister Tabitha, and Yuval Fiza, Brother Asim, Sister Sazid, and then Komal, and then Brother Ayas, Sister Janika, And finally, we have Sister Sonia. So as usual, what is going to happen next is that I'll be charging the baptismal candidate. So I'll be asking all of you a few questions. And at the end of the questions, you are to reply with a resounding yes. And then after charged, so after I charge the baptismal candidates, then I will charge the congregation as well. So now I shall charge the baptismal candidates in the presence of God and His people. In baptism, God calls you out of darkness into His marvelous light. To follow Christ means dying to sin and rising to new life with Him. Therefore, I ask you these following questions. Question number one, do you turn to Jesus Christ as your Savior and submit to Him as your Lord? Yes. So all of us heard them in the presence of God and in the presence of His people. Let's give them an encouraging claps. Second question, do you repent of the sins that separate us from God and our neighbors? Yes. Only a few from my back say yes. How about the front? do you repent from your sins that separate us from God and from our neighbors? Yes? Okay. Let us encourage them. Third question for all of you, do you desire to grow in Christ and to participate in the life of His body, the church? Yes. Yes, okay. So now we have heard the answers, a resounding yes from the candidates. Now I shall charge the congregation. So now that you have heard the declaration of faith from them, now it is your turn to answer these questions. So after each question, you will reply with, "We will." Will you accept these candidates into the body of Christ?
Yes.
Very good. Amen. Will you pray for these candidates, uphold them in their new life in Christ, draw them by example into the community of faith, and walk with them?
Yes.
Amen. Will you care for them? Will you support them, nurture them, equip them, and help them to take their place within the life and worship of the church so that they can continue to grow in Christ? Amen, amen. So now let us bow our heads and pray as we proceed with the baptism. Heavenly Father, we thank you for these candidates and their acts of obedience to you and your word. And by the power of your Holy Spirit, renew these candidates in the image of our Lord Jesus Christ. May Christ dwell in their heart through faith, that they may be rooted and be grounded in love and bring forth the fruit of the Holy Spirit. May they continue to walk by the light of faith and not by sight, and live victoriously in and through our Lord Jesus. Glory be unto our God forever and ever. And all God's people say, Amen. All right, now we shall proceed to the water baptism, and I will be calling out the baptismal candidates to go into the pool to be baptized. So the first candidate is Daniel. Let us welcome him. His Bible verse is John 6:68, which says, "Then Simon Peter answered him, 'Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life.'"
Brother Daniel, do you believe and do you declare that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior?
Yes, of course.
By your confession of faith, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The next candidate is Brother Yong Long, and his Bible verse is 2 Corinthians 5:17. "Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone, and the new is here."
Yong Long, do you believe in Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
I do.
By your confession of faith, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
And And now we have our next candidate, Daniel Go Wei Ping. So his verse is Galatians chapter 2, verse 20 to 21. I have been crucified with Christ. No longer I live, but Christ lives in me. The life I now live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. I do not set aside the grace of God, for if righteousness could be gained through the law, Christ died for nothing.
Daniel Go, do you believe and do you declare that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior?
Yes, I do.
By your confession of faith, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Now our next candidate is Yuan Lai Cheng, and the verse is Proverbs 3, 5 to 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your path straight.
LC Yuan Lai Cheng, do you declare that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior?
Yes, I do.
By your confession of faith, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Candidate is Lillian. John 15, 9 to 11 says, as the Father has loved me, so have I loved you. Now remain in my love. If you keep my commands, you will remain in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commands and remain in his love. I have told you this so that my joy may be it may be in you and that your joy may be complete.
Wen Lillian, do you believe that Jesus and declare that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior?
Yes, I do.
Need to be louder.
Yes, I do.
By your confession of faith, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
And next candidate is Zi'en, Yong Zi'en. So her verse is Ephesians 2, 8 to 9. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing. It is by the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast.
Yong Zi'en, do you believe and do you declare that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior?
Yes, I do.
By your confession of faith, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
And the next candidate is
Elise
Chin, and her verse is, for by grace you have been saved through faith. It's the same verse. And this is not your own doing. It is the gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast. Ephesians 2, 8 to 9.
Okay. All right, it's cold, huh? Elise Chin Jialin, do you declare and do you believe that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior?
Yes, I do.
By your confession of faith, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
And the next candidate is
Edison.
Brother Tang Chunyan. So the verse is Colossians 2, 6 to 7. So then, just as you receive Christ Jesus as Lord, continue to live your lives in him, rooted and built up in him, strengthened in the faith as you were taught, and overflowing with thankfulness.
Edison Tang Chunyan, do you
Brother Wee Jin Han. Pastor Li Zexian. And the verse is also Romans 8:18. I consider that our present sufferings are not worth comparing with the glory that will be revealed in us.
Brendan Lee.
And his verse is Proverbs 3:5 to 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not unto your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your path straight.
Jaden Koo, do you believe that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior?
Yeah, I do.
By a confession of faith, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
And his, verse is Galatians 2:20. I have been crucified with Christ, and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I now live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself to me.
Kendrick Kwan K. Fung, do you believe that Jesus Christ is your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
By a confession.
We have Pastor Akram in the pool beside Pastor Yu Yong to assist. So, the Lord is my shepherd, I lack nothing.
Melun Masih, kya?
To do. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning.
Vishal, kya tune khudaamdi Yesu Masih ko apne zindagi mein shakhsi nijaat deinda kabul kiya?
Yes.
Main tujhe khuda baap, khuda bete, khuda paakru ke naam mein baptisma deta hoon.
And the verse is 2 Samuel 22, verse 3. My God is my rock, in whom I take refuge, my shield and the horn of my salvation. He is my stronghold, my refuge, and my savior. From violent people, you save me. He will cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you will find refuge. His faithfulness will be your shield and rampart. तबीता
क्या आपने खुदावंद यीशु मसीह को अपनी जिंदगी में शख्सी निजात दहिंदा कबूल किया है?
जी मैंने किया है।
Psalm 123:2. As the eyes of slaves look to the hands of their master, as the eyes of a female slave look to the hands of her mistress, so our eyes look to the Lord our God till He shows us His mercy.
के नाम में बपतिस्मा देता हूं।
एंड द नेक्स्ट कैंडिडेट इज आयास मासे, नो साजिद मासे, सॉरी
साजिद मसीह, क्या तूने खुदावंद यीशु मसीह को अपनी जिंदगी में शख्सी निजात दहिंदा कबूल किया है?
Yes.
मैं तुझे खुदा बाप, खुदा बेटे, खुदा पाकरू के नाम में बपतिस्मा देता हूं। तूने खुदावंद यीशु मसीह को
The next candidate is Ayas Mase, and his verse is Luke 6:46. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and do not say and do not do what I say?
Ayas, क्या तूने खुदावंद यीशु मसीह को अपनी जिंदगी में शख्सी निजात दहिंदा कबूल किया है?
Yes.
मैं तुझे खुदा बाप, खुदा बेटे, खुदा पाकरू के नाम में बपतिस्मा देता हूं।
एंड द नेक्स्ट कैंडिडेट इज जनिका फारूक, एंड हर वर्स इज Psalm 17:2। लेट माई विंडिकेशन कम फ्रॉम यू, मे योर इयर्स सी व्हाट इज राइट, may your eyes see what is right. Thank you.
Janika, kya tune khuda yusuf si ko apni zindagi mein shakhsi nijat denda qabool kiya hai?
Ji.
Main tujhe khuda baap, khuda bete, khuda pakru ke naam mein baptisma deta hu.
Now we invite the next candidate, Sister Sonia. Sister Sonia.
Sonia, क्या तूने खुदावंद यीशु मसीह को अपनी जिंदगी में शख्सी निजात दहिंदा कबूल किया है?
जी।
मैं तुझे खुदा बाप, खुदा बेटे, खुदा पाकरू के नाम में बपतिस्मा देता हूं।
And now we invite the next candidate Sister Komal.
Komal, kya tune khudaon Yesu Masih ko apni zindagi mein shakhsi nijaat dehinda qubool kiya hai?
Ji.
Main tujhe khuda baap, khuda bete, khuda paakru ke naam mein baptisma deta hoon.
Pastor Young for conducting the Holy Holy Baptism for us. And so this concludes our baptism service, and after the service, the candidates, they will be coming to the front so that you can also come to the front to pray for the candidates as well. Now let us just bow our head in prayer. And just one thing before I pass the time to Pastor Daniel Jimmy later, we will also have our offering. But for now, let us pray for the candidates, and then we will do the offering. Now let's pray. Our Father in heaven, we thank you for the faithfulness of our brothers and sisters in Christ today in following your command to publicly testify their faith that you are their Lord and God, and they are your people. We pray that you will continue to bless them and help them as they grow in their faith. And also help us, the church, to love them, to welcome them into the body, to grow with them, to encourage them as we continue this journey of discipleship together. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, now we come to a time of offering. If you are a visitor with us, or if you have not, or if you are not a Christian, you have not placed your faith in Christ, you are not obligated to give this offering. We are just so glad that you are here worshiping and joining our service today. So I will just give you a minute or so to do this offering. You can scan the QR code, or you can also find this offering drop box located at different this doors of our sanctuary. Now let's welcome him.
Hallelujah. Shalom semua.
Shalom everyone.
Baik, kita bersyukur hari ini.
We are so grateful today.
Kita bukan hanya dapat menyembah Tuhan, memuji Tuhan bersama-sama.
Not only we get together here to worship Lord together.
Bahkan hari ini kita melihat beberapa jiwa telah menerima Yesus sebagai Tuhan dan Juru Selamat.
Also get the opportunity to witness all people just now get baptized.
Berikan sorak-sorai yang paling gemuruh untuk Tuhan kita.
Give hands to the Lord, praise the Lord.
Yes, hallelujah. Alright, sebelum saya masuk kepada sermon hari ini, untuk khotbah hari ini.
Before we get to the sermon,
saya mengajak kita untuk melihat satu video.
Let us watch a video.
Everybody's
Shalom. Terima kasih Pastor Daniel dan tim karena Anda semua telah melayani kami di SIB Kampung Jentung. Kami sangat diberkati dengan kunjungan Anda semua dalam misi revival yang Anda adakan. Dan kami harap kita dapat bertemu kembali di masa yang akan datang. Tuhan memberkati kita semua.
Baiklah, sebentar tadi adalah video sedikit, video pendek dari pelayanan BM.
So just now was a video. It was our revival ministry trip to the Orang Asli.
Yeah, thank you untuk setiap jemaat Tuhan yang telah menyumbang dari segi keuangan, makanan dan sebagainya untuk pelayanan ini.
Thank you for the nations for the mission trip that we had.
Dan saya percaya Tuhan akan terus memberkati setiap kita di tempat ini. Amen.
And I believe that the Lord will always like continue to bless us. Amen.
Yeah, berikan sorak-sorai bagi Tuhan kita.
Okay, praise the Lord.
Sudah siap untuk mendengarkan khotbah hari ini?
Are you guys ready to listen to the sermon?
Kalau yes, angkat tangan.
If it's yes, then raise up your hand.
Katakan yes.
Say yes.
Yeah, hallelujah. Alright. So hari ini kita akan bercakap tentang iman yang berkuasa.
So today we're gonna learn about faith that is powerful.
Katakan kiri dan kanan. Kita harus punya iman yang berkuasa.
Say to the right and left, we have to have a powerful faith.
Alright, okay. So hari ini, khotbah saya hari ini, saya akan mendasari firman Tuhan dalam Matius 17 ayat 14 hingga 20.
So let's read in the Bible from Matthew chapter 17 verse 14 until 20.
Oke, saya akan baca dalam BM dulu dan Nelly akan baca dalam bahasa Inggris. Oke. Oke, ketika Yesus dan murid-muridnya kembali kepada orang banyak itu, datanglah seorang mendapatkan Yesus dan menyembah. Katanya, Tuhan kasihanilah anakku. Ia sakit ayan dan sangat menderita. Ia sering jatuh ke dalam api dan juga sering ke dalam air.
So I will read it in English Standard Version. And when they came to the crowd, a man came up to him and kneeling before him, said, Lord, have mercy on my son, for he has seizures and he suffers terribly. For often he falls into the fire and often into the water.
16 dan 17, aku sudah membawanya kepada murid-muridmu, tetapi mereka tidak dapat menyembuhkannya. Ayat 17, maka kata Yesus, hai kamu angkatan yang tidak percaya dan yang sesat, berapa lama lagi aku harus tinggal di antara kamu? Berapa lama lagi aku harus sabar terhadap kamu? Bawalah anak itu kemari.
Verse 16, and I brought him to your disciples, and they could not heal him. And Jesus answered, O faithless and twisted generation, how long am I to be with you? How long am I to bear with you? Bring him here to me.
18. Dengan keras Yesus menegur dia, lalu keluarlah setan itu daripadanya, dan anak itu pun sembuh seketika itu juga. Ayat 19, kemudian murid-murid Yesus datang, dan ketika mereka sendirian dengan dia, bertanyalah mereka, mengapa kami tidak dapat mengusir setan itu?
Verse 18, and Jesus rebuked the demon, and it came out of him, and the boy was healed instantly. Then the disciples came to Jesus privately and said, why could we not cast it out?
Yang terakhir ayat 20, ia berkata kepada mereka, karena kamu kurang percaya, sebab aku berkata kepadamu, sesungguhnya sekiranya kamu mempunyai iman sebesar biji sesawi saja, kamu dapat berkata kepada gunung ini, pindah dari tempat ini ke sana, maka gunung ini akan pindah dan takkan ada yang mustahil bagimu.
Verse 20, he said to them, because of your little faith, for truly I say to you, if you have faith like a grain of mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you.
Nah, jemaat Tuhan yang saya kasihi, dengar baik, hari-hari ini,
brothers and sisters in Christ, nowadays,
hari-hari ini kita sangat memerlukan yang namanya iman.
Today is we need the things that we call faith.
Kenapa kita memerlukan iman dalam kehidupan kita?
Why do we need faith in our lives?
Karena hari-hari ini dunia sangat jahat.
Because nowadays the world is so cruel.
Dunia begitu menekan kita.
The world put so much pressure on us.
Iblis coba mencuri kita daripada tangan Tuhan.
so that the devil will always take us away to try.
Ada begitu banyak cara dunia untuk menarik kita keluar daripada Tuhan.
There's so many ways the devil wants to take us away from
That's
God.
That's why hari-hari ini kita memerlukan yang namanya iman.
That's why we need faith.
Kasih tahu kiri kanan, kita perlu iman.
Say to the left and right, we need faith.
Kita perlu iman hari-hari ini.
We need faith.
Karena dunia semakin hari semakin rosak.
Because the world is getting cruel and cruel.
Dunia jahat.
The world is cruel.
Dia mau curi saya dan saudara. Dia mau
curi. Yeah, the world will try to take us away from the Lord.
Hati-hati.
Be careful.
Iblis sedang mencari ruang.
The devil is trying to find and seek a way.
Mencari ruang untuk apa?
To seek a way for what?
Untuk mengeluarkan kita.
To take us away from God.
Hari ini.
Today.
Firman Tuhan yang kita belajar tadi.
The word of God that we've read just now.
Ada dua jenis manusia yang kita lihat.
There are two types of human.
Yang pertama.
The first one.
Orang yang tidak percaya dan sesat.
The non-believer and the heresy.
Siapa orang yang tidak percaya?
Who are those people who are not?
Seorang bapa yang membawa anaknya.
A father who brought his son.
Bapa itu bilang begini.
The father said,
Tuhan, bolehkah kau sembuhkan anak saya?
Can you heal my son?
Saya sudah bawa saya punya anak kepada murid-muridmu.
I brought my son to your disciples.
Tapi mereka tidak dapat menyembuhkan anakku.
But they can't do nothing, they cannot heal him.
Ini adalah orang yang tidak percaya dan sesat.
This is the example of a human.
Yang kedua, orang yang kurang percaya.
Human who lack of faith.
Siapa yang Yesus gelar orang yang kurang percaya?
Who are these people that Jesus called not
Muridnya
believe?
Sendiri.
His own disciple.
Come on, murid-murid Yesus bersama-sama dengan Yesus.
Disciple, the disciple has been with Jesus.
Mereka
the whole time.
Melihat apa yang Yesus lakukan.
They've seen Jesus done so many things.
Mereka melihat apa yang Yesus lakukan melalui mujizat.
They've seen Jesus done so many miracles.
Yesus sembuhkan orang yang sakit.
Jesus healed those who are sick.
Yesus membangkitkan orang-orang mati.
Jesus brought the dead to life.
Murid-murid Yesus bersama dengan Yesus.
And the disciple has been with Jesus all the time.
Hari-hari ini.
These days.
Berapa ramai di antara kita yang setiap minggu ke gereja?
How many of us have been going to church every Sunday?
Berapa ramai di antara kita hari ini yang menggelar diri kita sebagai orang Kristen?
How many of us calling themselves as believer?
Tapi akhirnya Yesus berkata ini, orang yang kurang percaya.
At the end Jesus said, we are the non-believers.
Persoalannya,
question is,
apa perbezaan antara orang yang tidak percaya dan sesat dan orang yang kurang percaya?
So what is the differences between the non-believer and heresy and those who are lack in faith?
Apa yang membezakan kedua hal ini?
What is the differences between the two?
Tidak ada beza.
There's no difference.
Dua-dua orang tidak percaya.
Both are non-believers.
Yang satu kurang percaya.
The one is not believe, non-believer.
Dan sesat.
And heresy.
Yang satu langsung tidak percaya.
And the other one totally not believing.
Sehingga apa yang terjadi?
So then what's gonna happen?
Dia tidak mengalami yang namanya mujizat.
So he or she cannot feel, cannot see or witness work of God.
Seberapa ramai di antara kita hari ini?
How many of us today?
Begitu banyak doa kita.
We've been praying so much.
Begitu banyak yang kita inginkan.
So many things that we want.
Begitu banyak yang kita bawa di kaki Tuhan.
There's so many offerings that we brought to
Tapi akhirnya kita tidak melihat apa-apa.
But then we cannot see anything.
Kamu tahu kenapa?
You guys know why?
Kurang percaya.
Because we lack of faith.
Dan saya percaya bahwa setiap kita hari ini di tempat ini.
And I believe every one of us today.
Apapun level imanmu.
Whatever level is our faith today.
Yesus melihat itu.
God sees us.
Amen.
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 Setakat ini boleh ikut khotbah saya?
You guys can follow the sermon.
Lambai-lambai tangan kalau boleh ikut saya. Di belakang ada yang sudah tidur. Jangan tidur supaya kita boleh belajar sesuatu.
Bear with us, don't sleep.
Nah, kita kembali kepada khotbah hari ini. Tahukah kita bahwa iblis berusaha untuk membuatkan kita tidak beriman?
So you guys know the devil tries so hard to make us not believe in God.
1001 cara iblis guna untuk membuatkan kita hilang iman kepada Tuhan.
There's thousands of ways the demon will use to make us
apapun
not believe
itu,
in God.
Apapun
whatever
cara,
it is,
iblis akan coba untuk kita hilang percaya kepada
the
Tuhan.
Demon will make us will not believe.
Apa yang terjadi kalau kita hilang percaya?
So what will happen if we not believe in God?
Kita hidup di dalam ketakutan kita.
We live in fear.
Kita takut untuk keluar.
We fear to go out.
Kita
there.
Takut untuk menyampaikan Injil.
We're scared to share the word of God.
Kita takut untuk bercakap tentang apa iman kita.
We're scared to share about our faith.
Kita takut untuk bersaksi.
We're scared to share the word of God.
Dan iblis senang dengan ketakutan-ketakutan yang sedang menguasai hidup kita.
So the devil will attack us with the fear.
Anak-anak muda.
Youth.
Dari apapun bahasa kita.
From whichever congregations.
Iblis sedang berusaha menghancurkan kita.
The devil trying so hard to destroy us.
Baru-baru ini.
Recently.
Istri saya kongsikan satu video di TikTok.
My wife shared a video on TikTok.
Dan video ini bercakap tentang kesaksian seorang pendeta di Indonesia.
And this is a video about a pastor in Indonesia.
Dia dikecam.
He was being.
Dia dikritik.
Yeah, he was being criticized.
Dia dikritik, dia dihentam. Kenapa?
Why?
Karena anaknya bunuh diri.
Because his son suicide.
Kenapa bunuh diri?
Why?
Karena dia dibully di sekolah.
Because he was being bullied at school.
Dan dia tidak kongsikan itu kepada orang tuanya.
And he never shared his problem with his
parents. Sehingga apa yang terjadi?
So what happened?
Dia depresi.
He got depression.
Dan bunuh diri.
And then he suicide.
Saya sangat menentang di tempat ini saya istiharkan. Saya sangat menentang orang yang tidak percaya dengan depresi.
Yeah, I really
menentang.
I'm against all those people who are not believe in depression.
Karena itu menyokong kepercayaan saya.
Yeah, because it supports to his belief.
Karena saya percaya ini, iblis itu coba berusaha untuk mencuri kita.
Yeah, because the demon always try to take us away.
Ketika kita mengizinkan, istri saya minta maaf. Istri saya adalah orang yang depresi dulu.
His wife used to be someone who's
sebelum
depressed.
Sebelum kami berkawin.
Before they got married,
saya mengambil keputusan untuk mau mengawini dia, sekalipun dia sudah mau bunuh diri 3 kali.
Yeah, he decided to get married with his wife.
Dia sudah tulis surat.
She already wrote a letter.
Dan saya percaya ada kuasa Tuhan bersama dengan saya.
Yeah, and Pastor Daniel believes that the power of God is with him.
Sehingga apa yang terjadi, saya tidak mau meninggalkan dia.
So what happened, even though his wife is battling or suffers from depression, he never like really think to like leave his wife.
Depresi adalah sebuah roh.
Depression is a spirit.
Lawan roh itu.
Fight the spirit.
Jangan tunduk kepada roh itu.
Don't bow to the spirit.
Kalau Anda ada dokter di tempat ini,
if there is any doctor here,
doakan orang itu.
Pray for that people.
Kamu tahu apa yang terjadi? Setelah saya berkawin dengan istri saya.
So what happened after they got married?
Saya tahu dia ada depresi.
He knows that she has depression.
Saya alami, saya tidak ada depresi, saya tidak anxiety, tapi istri saya ada.
He has no depression, anxiety, but his wife.
Selama kami berkawin, apa yang terjadi? Tuhan membentuk kami, Tuhan memproses hubungan kami.
So God processed them through their marriage.
Nah, depresi itu setelah kita doakan, kita follow up.
So after we pray for someone who's suffered from depression,
jangan tinggalkan.
We will follow up them. Don't let them alone.
Jadi seorang dokter yang juga bekerja, seorang dokter dan juga seorang pelayan Tuhan, kamu harus kerjakan ini.
So a doctor and a servant of God, this is what we do.
Doakan, follow up.
Pray for them and follow up.
Kenapa? Karena spirit perlu sembuh.
Why? Because spirit need some healing.
Dan jiwa dan mental juga perlu disembuhkan.
So our mental and our soul need to be
Saya ingin ceritakan satu kisah dengan saya dengan istri saya ketika saya istri saya terkena COVID 2020-2021 rasanya.
So in 2022 his wife got COVID.
Yeah. Then saya dia quarantine di bilik, saya di ruang tamu.
So his wife been quarantined in the room and he stayed outside.
Yeah. So apa yang terjadi? Istri saya mau makan bubur. Bubur mau makan bubur.
So every day they just ate porridge.
Yeah, dia mau makan porridge. Terus saya malas masak.
He's not really into cooking.
Dan saya keluar, saya take away makanan lah.
So he went out and look for food. Yeah.
So saya tanya istri saya, kamu mau makan apa?
So he asked his wife, what do you want to eat?
Dan dia kata, saya tidak mau makan apa-apa.
And she said, I don't want to eat anything.
Dan akhirnya saya bilang begini, sebagai seorang lelaki dan sebagai seorang suami yang mau menunjukkan yang kita ini romantik.
So he was thinking, me as a man, I have to be romantic.
Saya take away lah makanan untuk dia.
Oh, so he still he try to like choose any kind of food and book.
So saya beli makanan untuk dia, saya beli nasi lemak.
So he bought the nasi lemak.
Saya punya makanan nasi kari ikan.
So he bought nasi lemak for his wife and kari ikan for himself.
Apa harapan saya ketika saya beli? Harapan saya.
His what he expected.
So saya berharap supaya istri saya bilang, wow, bagusnya suami saya.
So he expected that his wife will say like, oh wow, my husband so nice.
Dan kamu tahu apa respon dia?
So you guys know what she responded him?
Saya bagi makanan, saya masuk rumah, saya bagi di dalam bilik. Karena quarantine, harus jaga jarak, saya bagi dan saya lari ke ruang tamu.
So he came home and gave the food to his wife.
Kamu rasa apa responnya?
Can you guess what's her response?
Wah, terima kasih suami yang baik.
Is it, oh thank you my dear husband.
Ih, bagusnya kamu.
You're so nice.
Memahami isi hati saya.
Understand me.
Kamu tahu, kamu rasa itu dia yang dia respon?
You guys think that's his wife?
Itu harapan saya.
That is his expectation.
Kamu tahu apa yang terjadi? Dia berdiam.
So actually the thing that happened during that day is opposite.
Dan dia bilang begini, saya tidak mau makan.
I don't want to eat. Instead she said, I don't want to eat.
Dan saya di luar di ruang tamu, saya duduk sambil makan.
And he stayed in the living room and eat.
Dan saya meluahkan hati saya sendiri. Saya bilang begini, saya sudah beli makanan, tapi kau tidak makan. Menyesal saya beli.
So he feel bad because he's alone in the living room eating while his wife doesn't even touch the food.
Dan rupanya istri saya dari bilik dia keluar dan dia cubuk saya dari jauh begini.
So his wife went out from the room and picked him in the living room trying to see what he's eating.
Dan dia dengar.
And he hears.
Dia bilang begini, kamu tahu saya kena COVID. Kamu tahu saya punya tekak sakit. Kenapa kamu beli nasi lemak?
So the wife got mad and she said, you know I'm not well, I'm sick, and I have sore throat.
Dan suara dia itu tinggi. Itu pertama kali saya dengar orang istri saya teriak begitu.
So his wife said those things with high pitch, which is it was the first time for him to hear from her.
Hampir yeah, saya pun kena anxiety.
He almost got anxiety.
Saya terkejut respon dia begitu.
He was surprised.
Dan kamu tahu, dia masuk bilik, dia menangis.
And then his wife got into the room again and cried.
Dan saya cubuk dari luar, saya tengok dia begini, dia menangis dan dia shaking.
And now he tried to pick his, take a pick his wife, what she's doing in the room.
Dan saya tahu, roh depresi itu mulai serang dia lagi.
And you know, at that moment, the depression is.
Dan dia duduk di tepi katil dan dia duduk seperti ini dan dia shaking.
Yeah, his wife was shaking in the room.
Dan saya bilang begini dengan dia. Saya bilang begini dengan Tuhan. Tuhan, apa yang sudah terjadi? Saya tidak boleh masuk ke dalam bilik sebab dia COVID.
So Pastor Daniel was confused by what he was about to do because he cannot even get into the room because his wife is not well, got COVID.
Dan akhirnya saya bilang begini.
And finally COVID, he said,
COVID lah. Saya lebih mengasihi istri saya.
So he said, COVID is COVID. I love my wife even more.
Dan saya buat keputusan untuk masuk ke dalam bilik.
To go into the room.
Saya masuk, istri saya COVID tau, COVID, positif COVID.
His wife was positive. COVID
saya waktu itu saya tidak percaya COVID.
And he used to not believe in COVID.
Dan waktu saya masuk dalam bilik,
and he came into the room.
Saya peluk dia.
He hugged her.
Saya peluk walaupun dia, itulah.
Yeah, even though his wife is like.
Tapi saya peluk. Saya peluk.
Yeah, he hugged her.
Saya bilang saya minta maaf.
He apologized to his wife.
Saya minta maaf. Kamu rasa respon istri saya apa? Kamu ingat dia bilang saya maafkan kamu? Tidak.
Yeah, so you guys, can you take a guess? Like, was his wife was saying, "Yeah, I forgave you." No.
Kamu tahu dia bilang apa?
You guys know what?
Saya COVID.
His wife said, "I have COVID."
Kenapa kamu masuk?
Why you came in?
Ah, di sanalah saya waktunya untuk saya jadi romantik. Saya bilang, karena saya mengasihi kamu.
So Pastor Daniel said, because I love you.
Dan saya peluk lagi dia.
So he hugged her again.
Dia sudah okay, dia tenang.
And now she calmed.
Dan akhirnya saya keluar lagi, karena dia masih COVID kan, saya keluar. Saya keluar.
So yeah, he then walked out of the room once.
Keesokan harinya.
Down.
Kamu tahu keesokan harinya apa yang jadi? Saya yang COVID.
The next day he got COVID.
Istri saya sembuh.
His wife recovered.
Nah, ini ketakutan-ketakutan, anxiety, depresi yang sedang mengikat dia.
Okay, so yeah, this is
anxiety dan depresi.
Yeah, anxiety and depression.
Dan akhirnya sampai hari ini, puji Tuhan sampai hari ini dia sudah dilepaskan.
So thank God because until this day his wife is already like.
Berikan kemuliaan untuk Tuhan kita.
Yeah. Delivered from the depression and anxiety.
That's why saya menentang. That's why saya sangat harus melayani orang-orang yang terikat dengan depresi dan anxiety.
Yeah, that's why I always like serve those people with depression.
Karena orang-orang seperti ini memerlukan kasih daripada
because
Tuhan.
Because these people need love.
Amin.
Amin.
Alright, mari kita next. Jadi di mana kita hari ini?
So where are we now?
Apakah kita hidup di dalam ketakutan?
Are we living in a fear?
Apakah kita hidup di dalam anxiety?
Are we living in anxiety?
Depresi?
Depression?
Tidak berani untuk bergaul dengan orang lain?
Scared of socializing with the other people, getting along with other people?
Ketahuilah bahwa iblis menggunakan rasa takut kita supaya iman kita tidak bekerja dalam kehidupan kita.
So that know that the devil always like use the fear so that in our faith we cannot see the works of God in our lives because we lack in faith.
Nah, catat baik bahwa musuh iman adalah ketakutan.
So listen carefully. The enemy to the faith is fear.
Ketakutan adalah sebuah alat iblis untuk membuatkan kita cemas dan menghancurkan kita.
So fear is the tools the demon use to make us feel anxious and to destroy us.
Bermula daripada ketakutan itu menjadi alat iblis sehingga bermula daripada pikiran kita sehingga mempengaruhi emosi kita.
So it starts from our thoughts that then will influence our emotions.
Pikiran yang takut.
So the fear.
Pikiran yang takut itu akan mempengaruhi hati kita.
It will affect our heart, our emotions.
Sehingga apa yang terjadi, emosi memerintahkan hidup kita sehingga kita tidak dapat melakukan hal yang positif.
So then the emotion will then rule our lives, then we cannot see or we cannot do anything positive.
Ketika ketakutan lebih besar, kita sukar untuk melihat bahwa kita punya Tuhan yang besar. Ketika ketakutan kita lebih besar, kita tidak dapat melihat Tuhan yang lebih besar.
When our fear is bigger than our faith, we cannot see that the Lord is bigger than anything.
So jangan izinkan ketakutan itu menguasai hidup kita.
So never let the fear rule over us.
Seorang bapak membawa anaknya tadi.
Just now a father brought his son.
Dia bukan ketakutan, tapi dia tidak percaya.
It is not because he
sehingga
is scared,
dia tidak
but
mengalami.
His lack in faith. He never witnessed.
Dia tidak mengalami yang namanya mujizat.
He cannot see the thing that called miracle.
Hati-hati dengan ketakutan-ketakutan yang kita alami saat ini.
Be careful with the things that make us fear.
Saya tidak tahu apa ketakutan kamu.
I don't know what you're scared of.
Mungkin ada di tempat ini keluarga kamu tidak bersama dengan kamu.
Maybe because some of our family members are not with us.
Dan kamu risau dengan mereka.
And you are worried about them.
Mungkin kamu risau tentang pekerjaan kamu.
Maybe you are worried about your work, your job.
Kamu risau tentang project kamu.
You are worried about your project.
Serahkan itu kepada Tuhan.
Surrender it all to God.
Dengar baik.
Listen carefully.
Secara sederhana, pagi ini, hanya message ini yang saya mau sampaikan.
This is the message that I want to.
Jangan takut untuk hidup.
Yeah, never fear, never scared of living.
Karena Tuhan berjalan bersama
because
dengan
God
setiap kita.
Because God is working with us.
Amin.
Amen.
Amin.
Amen.
Nah, Tuhan mau kita berjalan di dalam kuasa Tuhan.
So God wants us to walk in. To walk with God.
Iblis mau kita berjalan dalam ketakutan, tapi Tuhan mau kita berjalan di dalam kuasa Tuhan.
So the demon wants us to walk in fear, but God wants us to walk with Him.
Kenapa iblis tidak mau kita berjalan di dalam kuasa Tuhan?
Why the devil never wants us to walk with
Karena
God?
Karena kalau kita berjalan di dalam kuasa Tuhan, ada kemenangan yang Tuhan berikan bagi setiap kita.
Because when we walk with God, there are so many big things will happen in our lives.
Apapun persoalanmu.
Whatever it is that
apapun yang kamu alami pada saat ini,
whatever it is that we are
satu hal yang
right now,
saya percaya,
there's one thing that I believe.
Kemenangan Tuhan berikan kepada saya dan saudara.
Yeah, the God will always bring us to the victory.
Amen.
Amen.
Tuhan mau kita berjalan dalam kuasanya.
God wants us to walk in His power.
Tuhan ingin kita selalu berjalan dalam iman, bahkan iblis ingin kita berjalan dalam ketakutan.
Yeah, so God wants us to walk by faith.
Ingat, iblis senang ketika kita dalam ketakutan.
So remember, the devil really glad to see when we walk in fear.
Jemaat Tuhan yang saya kasihi,
brothers, sisters in Christ,
jangan lupa bahwa Dia,
never forgets that He, the Lord,
adalah Immanuel. Immanuel.
He is Immanuel.
Dia beserta dengan kita.
He's always with us.
Dalam ketakutan kita.
In fear.
Ketika kita mengizinkan Holy Spirit masuk ke dalam kita.
The moment we allow the Holy Spirit,
dan Holy Spirit yang drive hidup kita,
that the Holy Spirit drives us.
Kamu tahu apa yang terjadi?
Do you guys know what gonna happen?
Setiap dikala kita tidak berani untuk melangkah, dikala kita tidak berani untuk melangkah, ketika Holy Spirit yang drive hidup kita, setiap hidup kita, kita akan melihat penyertaan Tuhan.
When we walk by faith and let the Holy Spirit to guide us, we can see the miracles of God.
Amin.
Amen.
Percayakan hidupmu.
Surrender your life to God.
Apapun latar belakang kita.
Whatever it is, where you coming from.
Yang baru dibaptis tadi.
Those who were just baptized.
Hari ini kamu menerima Yesus sebagai Tuhan dan Juru Selamat.
You guys accepted the Lord Jesus as your Savior.
Hari ini iblis melihat.
Today the devil looking at you.
Iblis akan berusaha untuk menyerang kamu.
The devil will try to aim you, always try to aim you.
Kamu tahu kenapa?
You guys know why?
Sebab ketika kamu hidup di dalam Tuhan,
because when you live in God,
ada kuasa bersama
there
dengan
is a
kamu.
Power with you.
Ada kuasa bersama dengan
there's
kamu.
A power with you.
So jangan lihat iblis yang di sana.
At the moment when you see the devil standing right there.
Tapi lihat Tuhan yang ada di sini.
But remember God is always with us.
Amen.
Amen.
Berjuanglah. Berjuanglah. Saya percaya Tuhan akan memimpin setiap kita.
I believe that God is always with us.
Yang ketiga, kita harus berani untuk melangkah.
The third one, we have to dare to step ahead.
Ketika Bapak membawa seorang anaknya,
when the father brought his son,
dia bawa kepada Yesus.
He brought him to Jesus.
Yesus tidak bilang, sakit apa?
Jesus didn't ask, what's wrong with you?
Ada masalah?
Got problem?
Atau ada apa-apa yang terjadi?
Is there anything happen?
Tapi Yesus dengan berani mengusir.
But then Lord cast away.
Dia mengusir roh jahat yang ada di dalam anaknya.
Then Jesus cast away the devil inside from the son.
Jika ada roh-roh yang sedang mengganggu setiap kita hari ini.
If there's any bad spirit
di rumahmu,
at your home,
tempat kerjamu,
at your work,
di office,
in your office,
di toilet,
in your toilet,
usir,
chase them away,
halau dia,
chase them away,
harus lawan spirit-spirit yang bukan daripada Tuhan.
Yeah, we have to dare to fight the bad spirit.
Amin.
Amen.
Kita harus sadar bahwa kita punya Tuhan yang berani, justru kita juga harus berani.
So we have to realize that we have a powerful God so that we have to be brave enough because we have the powerful God.
Kalau hari ini,
so if today,
kamu adalah orang yang kuat di dalam Tuhan.
You are those people who are strong in God.
Satu hal yang saya mau sampaikan.
There's one thing that I want to say.
Bertenang.
Calm. Have some peace.
Relax.
Relax.
Jangan gelabah.
Don't be anxious.
Kenapa?
Why?
Karena iblis dapat lihat siapa di dalam kita.
Because the devil can see within us.
Iblis akan berusaha keras untuk mencuri sukacita dan ketenangan kita. Sehingga apa? Sehingga kita tidak berani untuk melakukan apa-apa keputusan.
So the devil will try so hard to take away our joy and our peace so that then we are not there to do anything or to make any decision.
Iblis berusaha untuk mencuri sukacitamu.
Yeah, the devil tries so hard to take away your joy.
Iblis berusaha untuk kacau pikiranmu.
The devil tries so hard to ruin or to destroy
kacau your hatimu. Thinking.
Your heart.
Supaya apa?
So why?
Supaya
so
kita
then what?
Tidak tenang.
So when we are not feel
supaya
calm.
Supaya hidup kita menjadi hidup yang takut lagi, takut kepada hal-hal yang tidak baik.
So we are not scared of doing things that against Lord again.
Tapi hari ini,
but today,
hiduplah tenang di dalam Tuhan.
Have peace in Lord.
Amen.
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 Kasih tahu kiri kanan, hidup dalam hadirat Tuhan.
Tell person left and right.
Boleh saya panggil tim pujian penyembahan?
Present worship team.
Hari ini.
Come up to the stage.
Hari ini.
Today.
Saya tidak tahu sejauh mana iman kita.
I don't know how far we've come in our faith.
Saya tidak tahu di mana kamu letakkan iman kamu.
I don't know where you put your faith.
Tapi dengar baik.
But then listen carefully.
Jika imanmu diletakkan kepada Tuhan yang benar, maka imanmu akan bekerja sehingga membawa Anda kepada kemenangan besar dan memandu Anda untuk berjalan dalam kuasa Tuhan.
So if your faith is placed in a true God, in a living God, then your faith will work until it brings you to great victory and leads you to walk in the power of God.
Fikirkan di mana Anda letakkan imanmu hari ini.
So think carefully where do you put your faith?
Kalau mungkin hari ini kedua golongan yang kita belajar tadi.
So there are two kinds of people that we learn today.
Mungkin kita salah satu di dua kategori tadi.
So maybe we are one of them.
Satu hal yang saya mau sampaikan.
There's one thing that I want to
bertobat.
Say.
Repent.
Repent.
Kembali kepada Tuhan. Jangan takut.
Don't be
percayakan
scared.
Hidupmu kepada Tuhan.
Believe you.
Amin.
Amin.
Kamu tahu lagu tadi karena salibmu?
You know the song just now karena salibmu?
Mengatakan ini, karena salibmu ku hidup, karena salibmu ku menang. Engkau yang berkuasa sanggup untuk melakukan mujizatmu di hidup. Karena salib 2000 tahun yang lalu Yesus mati di atas kayu salib untuk saya dan saudara.
2000 years ago Jesus died on the cross for us.
Ketika Yesus mati di atas kayu salib,
the moment he died on the cross,
kemenangan diberikan kepada kita.
Victory has been given to us.
Dosamu telah diampuni.
Your sin has been forgiven.
Dan bagi yang baru dibaptis sebentar tadi,
for those who've been baptized just now,
Anda melakukan keputusan yang tepat.
You did the right thing.
Anda akan menerima keselamatan daripada Tuhan.
Receive victory from God.
Amen.
You've been saved.
Boleh kita berdiri bersama-sama? Kita angkatkan penyembahan ini bersama-sama dengan tenang, boleh? Karena salibmu ku hidup, karena salibmu ku menang, Engkau yang berkuasa sanggup untuk melakukan mujizat-Mu. Karena salib-Mu ku hidup, karena salib-Mu ku menang, Engkau yang berkuasa lagi, katakan karena salib-Mu ku hidup, karena salib-Mu ku menang, Engkau yang berkuasa Bapa. Terima kasih Tuhan buat pagi ini kami dapat bersama-sama untuk belajar kebenaran firman-Mu. Kami tahu Tuhan mungkin sekalipun kami berbeza bahasa, tapi kami percaya bahwa Roh Kudus-Mu akan terus berbicara dalam setiap hati kami. Bekerjalah Tuhan, lawatlah setiap kami. Berkati setiap jemaat Tuhan, berkati firman Tuhan yang kami belajar sebentar tadi. Biarlah kebenaran firman Tuhan yang kami istiharkan di tempat ini, firman Tuhan yang penuh dengan kuasa, sehingga sanggup memenangkan setiap pribadi kami. Berkati setiap jemaat Tuhan, berkati setiap anak-anak Tuhan di tempat ini. Apapun pergumulan mereka, apapun persoalan mereka, apapun ketakutan-ketakutan yang mereka hadapi dalam kehidupan mereka, ataupun mungkin ada di antara kami di tempat ini yang masih terikat dengan roh depresi, anxiety dan segalanya Tuhan, roh-roh yang tidak berkenan di hadapan-Mu, dari tempat ini hamba-Mu berdoa di dalam nama Yesus, segala kuasa-kuasa roh jahat yang tidak berkenan di hadapan-Mu, kami mau cabut di dalam nama Yesus. Dan mulai hari ini setiap jiwa, setiap kami di tempat ini akan mengalami perjumpaan bersama dengan Engkau, dan setiap kami di tempat ini akan mengalami kemenangan, lepas kemenangan yang terjadi dalam kehidupan kami. Terima kasih Bapa, terima kasih Tuhan, berkati setiap kami. Biarlah firman Tuhan yang kami dengar mendapat tempat di dalam setiap hati kami, supaya hidup kami dipimpin oleh kebenaran firman Tuhan. Terima kasih Bapa, terima kasih Yesus, ini doa kami di dalam nama Yesus. Setiap yang percaya dan menerima berkat dan urapan baru daripada Tuhan, mari sama-sama kita katakan amin. Haleluya. Berikan sorak-sorai. Terima kasih. Tuhan memberkati. Oke, sebelum kita keluar dari tempat ini,
so before we go home,
sekali lagi kita akan menerima berkat daripada Tuhan.
So once again we will receive blessing from
God. Boleh angkat tangan semua sama-sama.
Raise up your hand together.
Dan mari saya berdoa. Tuhan Yesus, terima kasih buat hari ini. Setiap kami di tempat ini berbeza bahasa, tapi kami menyembah Tuhan yang sama. Berkati setiap jemaat Tuhan, berkati setiap anak-anak Tuhan di tempat ini. Sekali lagi, apapun pergumulan mereka, Engkau berikan jawaban. Apapun persoalan mereka, Engkau bawa mereka keluar daripada setiap persoalan kami. Terima kasih Bapa, dari tempat ini hamba-Mu berdoa supaya ada berkat Tuhan yang melimpah, yang tercurah dalam setiap kehidupan kami. Apapun pekerjaan kami, apapun yang kami kerjakan, kami percaya kami berhasil karena Tuhan bersama dengan kami. Terima kasih Bapa, terima kasih Yesus. Jemaat Tuhan, pulanglah dengan membawa berkat daripada Allah Bapa. kasih karunia daripada Yesus Kristus, persekutuan Roh Kudus yang menyertai kita hari ini sampai selama-lamanya. Setiap jemaat Tuhan yang menerima berkat, mari sama-sama kita katakan, amin. Haleluya, selamat berhujung minggu, Tuhan memberkati.
Happy Sunday, see you again, God bless.